The Versatech single-phase recloser by Hubbell Power Systems offers versatile and reliable protection for distribution circuits that has been field-tested for more than a decade. Timestamp demand and event logging and field programmability allow for customers both to review circuit data and to quickly and easily change settings based on load changes and fault magnitudes. This field programmability allows for additional load and devices to be added to or removed from a circuit without rolling a bucket truck to connect to the recloser or requiring a change out of the Versatech recloser to retrofit that specific application. The Versatech recloser may be easily programmed prior to deployment in the field or after it is installed at any time. Accordingly, users have various options for programming and communicating with the recloser. These options include two types of wireless radio: cellular radio or hardwired serial connection. For example, programming the recloser prior to deployment may be done through a hardwired serial connection. The option to connect serially to the VT recloser is done through a serial port, accessible on the side of the housing which powers the unit without use of the battery or applied current. After deployment in the field, the user may wish to reprogram the Versatech according to a load change on that circuit. This can be done from the ground via a wireless 900 MHz or Wi-Fi connection, or remotely via a cellular connection. As the radio and power to broadcast the signal are included in the Versatech, no additional equipment is required to communicate with or program the unit. At most, the user will need a hook stick to toggle a handle to power the radio in cases where there is insufficient line load, or the settings programmed to not power the radio via line load. Once the connection is formed, the user can modify any of the settings through Hubbell Power Systems' proprietary UI. To connect to the serial port of a Versatech recloser, the user will need a supplied 0.226 hex tool. The cover over the serial port, or if externally attached, radio can both be removed with a hex tool to expose the DB9 or DB15 serial port. Using a DB9 to USB or DB15 to USB cable, the user can connect to a Windows-based PC on which the Versatech programmer user interface is installed. Note that a battery is not required to form a serial connection to the recloser. When the UI is opened, the VT will appear in the communications list as a COM port. Simply select the correct COM port and then select Identify Device, and the VT will be identified as a Versatech recloser in the communications list. The user may then connect to the device to establish a communication session. The RXD button will then illuminate green to indicate that a connection has been established, and the status will show success. As well, the recloser time, recloser serial number, and radio address, if available, will be displayed. A main difference the user will see when connecting to a Versatech 2 or Versatech XC recloser is that the UI requires the user to enter a username and password associated with a user profile. Default credentials are supplied in the instruction manual for an administrator profile and may be changed by the user anytime. For added security, 5 user levels are available, with various permissions allotted to each. Each user profile may be assigned a user level when created, and up to 8 user profiles are available for programming. To connect to a Versatech that has an internal or external 900 MHz radio, the user will need a corresponding local radio coupled to the PC. To power the wireless 900 MHz radio located on the Versatech recloser, either sufficient line load or an internal battery on the Versatech will need to be used. Sufficient line load for all Versatech reclosers is 10 amperes, except for the Versatech XC. The Versatech XC requires only 6 amps to power its internal radio. If sufficient line load is not present, the Versatech can utilize its internal battery to power the radio. A battery is included with each Versatech recloser and can be easily installed by sliding the battery into the receptacle and securing it via channel lock on the battery cap. To power the radio for up to 1 hour from the battery, simply rotate the red NR handle to the down position. When the user is done programming the Versatech, this red NR handle may be rotated back up to immediately shut off the radio and discontinue radio usage of the installed battery. Once the local radio is connected to the user's PC and the wireless radio is powered on the Versatech recloser, the Versatech connection will be displayed as a COM port in the communications list at the upper left of the UI. As with the serial connection, the COM port needs first to be selected and then to be identified by clicking on Identify Device. After identifying the VersaTech, the Connect button will be made available for selection to establish communications with the Recloser. To offer additional versatility, a VersaTech including an internal or external Wi-Fi radio may be communicated with via several means. Specifically, a user may connect to the VersaTech via a Windows-based PC, iPad, or iPhone. To communicate over Wi-Fi, the user first needs to connect to the VersaTech access point in the Wi-Fi networks list. A factory default password for the network is provided in the instruction manual or can be given to you by your local HPS representative. After establishing a connection to the Recloser Wi-Fi network, the VersaTech Recloser will be displayed in the communication list of the UI. Unlike the serial or 900 MHz radio connections, the Wi-Fi connection does not need to be identified first. The user may simply select that connection and immediately connect to the VersaTech Recloser.